What's up guys, in this short tutorial, I will show you how to fix the issue when you are unable to launch Apex Legends and if it's crashing on startup on Windows 11. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. First, open up your File Explorer and navigate to the drive on which you saved the game on. In my case, it's my D drive. From here, navigate to Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Apex Legends, Easy Anti-Cheat. Double-click the Easy Anti-Cheat Setup application, and after a second, this window will open up. Here, make sure to select Repair Service. This should only take a few seconds to complete, and you can close the window when it's finished reinstalling. Next, navigate back to the Apex Legends folder. Scroll down and right-click R5 Apex. Select Properties. In the Compatibility tab of this window, select to run this program in compatibility mode for Windows 7. In your settings, make sure to disable full screen optimizations. Don't forget to apply your changes. After applying your changes, you can close this window and your File Explorer. For Steam users, open up your Steam library. You can do the same step in your Epic Games or Origin Launcher. Right-click Apex Legends and select Properties. In the Local Files tab, select Verify Integrity of Game Files. This will take a minute to re-download and replace any missing or corrupted game files. In order to optimize Apex Legends to run on your system, I suggest using some launch options. These will all be listed in the extensive guide linked in the description below. In case the issue persists, then make sure that your graphics card driver and operating system is up to date. I suggest using the GeForce Experience application if you're using an NVIDIA graphics card, but you can also use the AMD driver suite. In the Drivers tab, simply click on Download and the application will automatically download and install the latest driver. In the Home tab, click on Details for Apex Legends. You will be presented with the current and optimal in-game settings. You have the option to let the application optimize the settings for you, or click on the wrench icon to do it yourself. Optimize your settings for performance. You can always change the settings back once you're in-game. You should, in addition, set the resolution to your native monitor resolution and launch the game in windowed mode to make sure that it's launching properly. In your GeForce Experience settings, make sure to disable the in-game overlay in the General tab, as some application overlays can cause the game to crash or not launch properly. Next, search for Update in your Start menu search to open up your Check for Updates System Settings window. Click on Check for Updates, and after downloading the latest OS update, make sure to restart your PC. In case you still experience startup issues, then you most likely have software running on your system, which is hindering you from playing the game. To fix this, I suggest uninstalling recently installed programs which can change your files, or use up your available resources, such as OBS, ShadowPlay, CCleaner, or Adobe applications, to troubleshoot which program is causing the error. In some cases, even your firewall or antivirus application can negatively impact the game's anti-cheat. Open up your Task Manager by right-clicking your taskbar and selecting it. In the Processes tab, make sure to end programs from running which you don't need while playing the game and which could trigger the anti-cheat software. In addition, close applications which could show an overlay while in-game. As a last resort, make sure to delete your temporary files. Search for percentage temp percentage in your Start menu search and hit Enter. A new folder will open up, containing all of your temporary files. These files are saved by your programs and should be deleted from time to time. Use the shortcut Ctrl and A to select everything and delete the content. Some files may remain, so just leave them there. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.